like the one on your sleeve. There happened a story you must see to believe. Way up in the mountains in the high range of Pontus lay the small town of Whoville, the home of the Whos. Ask any who, and they'll have this to say. There's no place like Whoville around Christmas Day. All the windows are flocked and every lamppost is dressed, and the Whoville band marching their Christmas Eve best. Arbor Day was fine and Easter was pleasant, and every St. Fizz's Day they ate a fizz pheasant. But every who knew, from their 12 toes to their snout, they loved Christmas the most without a single who doubt.
And it's a farm for Brother Drew, and it's a farm for your sister Sue, a muggle for your uncle, and a fan for your aunt. So now we just need...
Dad?
Yeah?
Doesn't this seem a bit much?
This is what Christmas is all about. Can't you feel it?
Another minute closer to Christmas. Only 99% off.
Boy, nothing beats Christmas.
Geez, I'm very impressed.
This, however, is new.
night, sweetie.
Well, good night, Betty.
Thank you.
Cindy Lou, who had some questions in her curious heart, why did the Grinch hate Christmas? Where did it all start? With her dad's plum quarter, she wouldn't give an inch.
Yes?
I'm here to ask Ms. Martha May some questions about the Grinch.
Don't be a ridiculous theory. Now run along and go home.
Hello,
Cindy.
Did you say I have some questions for you about the Grinch?
Yes, but since you're all here, please, please tell me in your own words, why does the Grinch hate Christmas and where did it all start?
Oh, yeah, no color connection, although I hardly remember him. I start to receive such love.
Well, truth be told, Martha was my girlfriend, and the Grinch liked Martha. I don't like discussing this so close to Christmas, but if you know the truth, you'll know why. He had hair, not pleasant. He shed, not right. He had a beard in elementary school, not fair.
Did I have a crush on the Grinch then?
I didn't ask you that.
All right, well, last time I remember seeing him, we were in school. It was almost time for a new relationship.
Short days, Hoobu will celebrate yet another wonderful Hoobulation. Now everyone knows the important part of Hoobulation and Christmas is gifts. So in honor of the spirit of Christmas and Hoobu practices, let us begin our gift exchange.
I thought the best part was no.
Okay, kids, let's run the line, please.
You know Christmas is my favorite time of year. I just love the colors right here.
Sally Sue, why don't you go first?
This year I decided to give myself the gift. After all, I've been working so hard on my studies. One day I'm going to be the mayor of Whoville.
Gift is a stupid heart ornament, one who will make you think anyone will ever like you.
The anger. You didn't go to school here. Now that I'm full of maturity and grown, I can tell now that we've been a hair too honest with him. But, I mean, he didn't hurt me. It's not like he won the fight.
It's not how it looked on YouTube.
And that's the last time
we
saw him, the very last time.
And after the young kids had their laughs in their way, the Grinch's heart shrunk two sizes that day.
Oh well, another man's toxic sludge is another man's potpourri. I don't know, somehow soap. Excellent year, Max. I don't know why I'd ever leave this place. I have all the company I need, right here. Hello!
Hello!
How are you?
How are you?
I asked you first.
I asked you first.
Oh, that's real mature, saying exactly what I say. I'm an idiot!
You're an idiot!
Alright, fine. I'm not talking to you anymore. In fact, I'm just gonna whisper so by the time my voice reverberates off the walls, you will not be able to hear it. Am I just eating because I'm bored? Get the stick, just get the stick. There's no stick.
You have no messages.
All right, better check the outcome.
If you utter so much as one syllable, I'll punch you down and gut you like a fish. If you'd like Is your Sub-Zero accelerator running?
I suppose.
Well, you better go catch it! That was good, Max. That was rich.
One thing, the Grinch will never come down.
But he doesn't
what more or less.
Blasts Christmas music. It's joyful and triumph. Must drown them out. Not working!
Whoever wins, whipped high above the hotel. A trooper slid beside all the way down. But this girl had a mission. She knew what to do. She invited the Grinch herself, that brave Cindy Lou.
Mr. Grinch.
Hello, little girl. How dare you enter the Grinch's lair? The audacity, the gall. You've called down the thunder. Now get ready for the boom. Gaze in the face of fear.
My name is Cindy Lou Who.
See, even now the terror is welling up inside of you.
I'm not scared.
Oh, denial. Another unmistakable sign of the heebie-jeebies. Run for your life before I kill again! I'm psycho! Desensitized by movies and television. What do you want?
I'm here to ask you to be holiday cheermeister.
The hollow would be what?
Cheermeister.
Cheermeister? Celebration with friends? Ha! How's it going?
I know you hate Christmas, but what if it's all just a misunderstanding?
Don't care.
But maybe if you reunite with the Who's, you can be a part of Christmas.
Maybe you can reunite with the Who's and be a part of Christmas.
Grow up!
Maybe it'll be all right for me, too.
I'm sorry, your session's over. Please make another appointment with the receptionist on your way out.
Please, please, you have to accept the award.
Award? You never mentioned an award.
Yeah, with the trophy and everything.
And I won.
You won.
And there are losers?
I guess, so if you come.
Oh, a town full of losers. I like it. Was anyone emotionally shattered? Come on, a minute ago, can you check out details, details?
The mayor wasn't too happy.
Oh, no.
Martha will be there.
Oh, she will?
Mm-hmm.
And she'll see me, a winner. She'll be on me like fleeble flies or a flat-placed fleeble horse.
So, will you come?
Oh, all right. I don't know if it's that adorable twinkle in your eye or that nonconformist streak that reminds me of a younger, less hairy me, but you've convinced me. Who knows? This humiliation could change my entire outlook on life.
Really?
No. The nerve of those Who's inviting me down there in such short notice. Even if I wanted to go, what would I even... I mean, my schedule would not even allow it. 4 o'clock, wallow in self-pity. 4:30, staring into the abyss. 5 o'clock, sophomore hunger, tell no one. 5:30, jazzercise. 6:30, dinner with me. I can't cancel that again. 7 o'clock, wrestle with my self-loathing. I'm booked, but what would I wear?
It's time for the Holiday Cheermeister Award. Congratulations, Mr. Grinch! Wait, he didn't show? Oh, he didn't come? Well, what happened was...
Hello, Martha.
For years now, I've put up with it.
Bravo! If you're not gonna help me, then you might as well.
Then he got an idea. An awful idea. The Grinch got a wonderful, awful idea.
I know just what I'll do.
The Grinch laughed in his throat. What if he had a Santa Claus hat and a coat, and he chuckled and clucked at this great Grinchy tree?
What if I had a hat and a coat? I'll just like Saint Nick. Ho, ho, ho.
Ho, 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 ho. Merry Christmas.
That boy should be finished up by now. Talk about recluse. He lives up there probably to avoid the taxes. Oops, forgot the reindeer.
Did that stop the old Grinch? No, the Grinch simply said,
if I can't find a reindeer, I'll make one instead. Oh, Max!
So he called his dog Max, and he took some red thread and tied a big horn on the top of his head.
You're a mean one, Mr. Grinch. You really are a mean one.
You're as ugly as a cactus. You're as charming as a neo, Mr. Grinch.
You're
a bad banana with a greasy black beard.
All right, you're a reindeer. Something is missing.
All the windows were dark, quiet, snow filled the air. All the Whos were all dreaming sweet dreams without care. When he came in the first little house on the square,
come on, Max. This is our first step.
The old Grinchy claws hummed and hissed, and he climbed to the roof, empty bags in his fist. He slid down the chimney in a rather tight pinch, but as Santa could do it, and so could the Grinch. He got stuck only once for a moment or two.
Glass water weight goes right to my hips.
They stuck his head out of the fireplace flue.
Shh, a little more stealth, please.
And the little whose stockings all hung in a row.
These stockings,
he grinned,
are the first to go.
They slunk to the icebox.
Shunk.
He added his feet. He took the hoop hoodie. He took the roast beast.
Quick.
He cleaned out the icebox as quick as a flash. By the Grinch, he went to the last can of mash. Then he stuck all the food out the chimney with glee.
And now,
grinned the Grinch,
I'll stuff up the tree.
And the Grinch grabbed the tree, and he started to shove when he heard a small sound like the coo of a dove. The Grinch had been caught by this tiny new daughter who got out of bed for a cup of cold water. But you know, that old Grinch was so smart and so slick, he thought up the lie and he thought it up quick.
Oh, my sweet little tot.
The fake Santa Claus lied.
There's a light on one side of this tree that will not light up, so I'm taking it to my home, my workshop, and I'll fix it up there and I'll bring it back here. What? Vengeance, I mean, presents, I suppose.
In his fitful witch hall, then he patted her head and he got her a drink and sent her to bed.
What? Sweet. I think he's sweet.
And when Stella Lou went up with her cup.
Sweet kid, bad judge of character.
He went in the chimney and stuffed the tree up. And the last thing he took was a log for the fire. On the walls, he left nothing but some hooks and some wire. And the one speck of food that he left in the house was a crumb that was even too small for a mouse. Then he slithered and slunk with a smile most unpleasant around each hoop home, and he took every present 3,000 feet up the side of Mount Crumpet. He rode with his load, then a tip-top to dump it.
Yes, yes, we did it, we did it, we did it. That wasn't so hard, was it? They'll be waking up now, and I'll know just what they'll do. They'll cry boo hoo hoo hoo. Destroy Christmas! But did anyone listen to me?
I did.
No, you listened to a little girl, a little not to be taken seriously girl, wasn't even thrown into her nose yet. Cindy, I hope you're very proud of what you've done.
If she's not, I'm glad. I'm glad he took our presents.
You're glad. You're glad the Grinch virtually wrecked Christmas? No, pulverized Christmas? Is that what I'm hearing from you, Lou?
Mr. Mayor, sir, you- enjoy Christmas, because it's not about the gifts or the fancy lights or the contest. That's what Cindy's been trying to tell us all, and me. She's been trying to tell me that too. There is a reason for the season, the one ultimate gift that he gave to us all, including the Grinch.
This is a child.
And she's my child, and she happens to be right, by the way. I don't need anything more of Christmas than right here, my faith and my family. Merry Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas.
Give me a break.
Merry Christmas.
And Mary gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in cloth and placed him in the manger because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were shepherds out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks by night. Suddenly an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and they were afraid. "Fear not," the angel said to them, "for I will bring good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born. He is Christ the Lord."
Silent night, no holy night, no all is calm, 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 calm
Then the Grinch heard a sound rising over this hill. It started in low, then it started to grow. But the sound wasn't sad. Why, this sounded merry, but it was merry, very. Every who down in Whoville, tall and the small, were singing without any presents at all. He hadn't stopped Christmas from coming. It came.
It came without boxes, bags, or tags.
And he puzzled and puzzled till his puzzler was sore. Then the Grinch thought of something he hadn't before.
Maybe Christmas does not come from a store. Maybe it just means a quite bit more.
And what happened then? Well, in Whoville, they say that the Grinch's small heart grew three sizes that day.
What's happening to me? I feel a toast inside. Max, I love you. That's enough. Get, beat it. Get out of here. Get. Cindy, what are you doing down there?
I came to see you. No one should be alone for Christmas.
Yeah. Help me out here. Martha?
Merry Christmas, Augustus, my home. But I'm afraid I have something for you. You're right back, because my heart belongs to somebody else.
No hard feelings, bud. It's Christmas. Cheer up.
So he brought back the toys and the food for the feast, and he himself, the Grinch, carved the roast beast.